going on, Sass Templars? Carry on. I guess that's a tall neck I can use.
Explosions in the distance.
Pay that no mind. It doesn't concern you. Getting close now. Head for that ridge. The tall neck's just over this ridge. You'll see it when you reach the top. Now be ready to act fast. You need to get in and get it done before they raise an alarm. Here we go.
That was close. I can't. I just need. I actually worked that time.
You getting this? I see the legs of a tall neck down there, but no tall neck.
Damn. The transmitter's been moved. Check down the ravine to the left. Only place it could be.
So much for your insider knowledge. Toward the explosions. Great.
You got exactly one shot at this, Aloy, so spare the sarcasm and make it count. You see that bridge over the ravine?
Yep.
Memorize its location. There's a rappel point on the side. That'll be your way out.
And these eclipse troopers?
Avoid them or kill them, your choice. The blasting should cover any noise you make. Find the tall neck and destroy the module on top.
Go.
Blasting all day and all night. Can't sleep, can't think. I do it for my people, for Marie.
Still sniffing around.
By the sun!
Oh my god, stop hitting me! So many of you hit. I should have got some health packs thingies. Oh, I've done this one. So.
Incoming! Missed.
one way out of this. Fight!
You will not escape the shadow. Get ready for the shadow sting.
Is that all? You're like the last one, other than this guy.
You're finished.
Is there fighting up ahead?
No. It's a binding operation. So long as you're quick, it won't affect you.
Oh, good. Another secret. That shelter. It's bigger than the others.
Find the tall neck, Aloy. There's no time to poke around.
There is if you make time. This is his shelter. Not exactly fancy.
When someone refuses to come, fanatic, I think of our wedding night. Against us his brutality.
Now you welcome me to the marital bed.
Just enough to want a stomach.
Now, Asher, when you fell asleep, I lay there.
He's a fanatic, all right. Single-minded.
It gives him a focus that you seem to lack. Now, how about finding that tall neck?
It would not have been easy to drag the tall neck down this path. Why bother?
Just find it and get to the top. Destroy the module, and then get out fast as you can.
Sure is a lot of blasting up there. Sounds busy.
Busy enough not to notice you, let's hope.
I see it. They've built some kind of structure around it.
Climb it. The sooner this is done, the better.
I don't like this. It feels wrong.
Everything here is wrong. Just get to the module and destroy it.
Wait, well, I'm confused. This way down, I guess.
Closing in on a signal. Module.
Good. Now be quick.
This is Hades?
Aloy, this is not the time.
It's a metal devil.
Open the module's casing, now. Aloy, do as I say or all is lost. Keep moving or you'll die.
Oops, I'm dead.
Keep moving!
Oh my god, wow. Lol. That's the problem. Don't have enough room for this.
Moving.
Kind of weird it is.
This looks easy. Yeah, you think? What do you think I'm doing? Taking a nap?
Rough going, but you survived.
You knew Hades was there, and you sent me to him?
I won't deny I risked your life, but it was the only way. Now, with the Focus Network down, we can both get what we want. Access to the secrets of Zero Dawn.
I'm past trusting you with secrets.
Good. That means you're wising up. Trust is for fools. It shifts and crumbles like sand. A poor foundation for any partnership. But mutual self-interest. Now that is a solid bedrock upon which you and I might build a new science of understanding. We both need answers, Aloy. And thanks to you, we're on the verge of grasping them. It's not for... We'll speak again.
You miserable... Damn him. If I could toss this focus and be rid of you, Silence, I would. But we both know I need it. Son of all it is. And Zero Dawn.
Okay, Let me, you know, fast travel it. So, course, it's here we can flash our tool. I should have chosen one with a bored head, but whatevs. Loading. Okay. Is there any, what do you call it, animal sites anyway? No. Okay, good. I guess we're going to have to go by foot for the rest of right now.
You're down soon enough. I'll shake it out later.
We made myself another travel pack in. We can make two. I don't know. I don't know what I exactly need to make one. This is not like you survived by us.
I'll tuck that away.
Doing well so far. I'm just rolling away. Rolling it. Whoa, who's that? That's a big mass. I don't even know it, absolutely. It's cool. Either cool. Which is okay, as long as he's not directly attacking me, I'll be okay. Okay, some bored heads around, but yeah, I'll get this one up there. Travel rest right then. So why the dogs are barking, but they're barking. Gonna be careful soon. Okay. Alright, come here. Now let's go. Dog, stop barking, please. guessing someone at the door, I don't know. My god. Dogs won't shut up. What are bad guys? You are bad guys, right? Oh, you good guys. Oh, you good guys, sorry. Dog shut up, I guess.
Sunfall. The Mad King drowns Summer Palace. A bulwark of Carja might against the howling from the east.
Thanks for the history lesson.
But they have no idea what lies beneath. We will learn much from this Aloy.
That's what I'm hoping. She's very...
Yeah, her name is... Where is Gali? Perhaps... Well... Last...
Okay.
I'll keep them moving.
Oh, wow. Dogs. Oh my god, they want shit to fuck up.
A soldier delivered my rations today. When I asked about the old fellow, all he said was...
Finish
him.
Is this ceasefire gonna put more food on
our
tables?
Yeah, Shadow Carja.
You'll regret not stopping when you're in the thick of it.
Uh-huh.
The Sun Ring. A proud tradition of Carja.
Stay off my focus.
If the eclipse catches you here, you'd be lucky if you... Now we get to see if your attack on their focus network was entirely successful.
What are you talking about?
Success.
Whoa.
Welcome to the Citadel, Aloy. I'll check back with you in a moment. In the meantime, circulate.
Outlanders! If you want to hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room. You're not going to make any shards by standing out here.
I'll take the shards, even if it means having a lift in a bar.
Their own.
By the glory of the sun revealed, behold, Radiant Edelman, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law!
Huh.
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of Radiant Edelman does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little huntress. The green tent down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting.
Kind of busy.
And in doing so, demonstrated wanton disregard for the safety. We both know you're no killer for hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel. Gotta see the Sun Ring from on high.
Well, the Kestrels.
Ah, they want us to see this, boy. It makes quite an impression.
Hardly.
They're going to see me.
The balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
Dog, shut the fuck up, please. I love you and all, but you're annoying. Here we go.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
I'm gonna get down. The floor's right there.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend into the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused. No distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride. I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels, only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure. As year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And, voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Yeah, of course it's
for identiscan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
I underestimated. So by now, I...
have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Mm-hmm. Come on in, let's go, 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 go.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
Please take a seat and wait for your name to be called. A selection of beverages and snacks are available.
In a smaller room.
Please proceed into viewing room one for an important message regarding the purpose of your visit.
Okay.
Holographic theater.
CD01 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top-secret super-weapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague, if Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super-weapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating, waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day, the day that life on Earth ceases to exist, is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris. Out.
Okay, can I pause it now since this episode? Thanks for that, Uber. We're still alive. Probably hundreds of years. Okay. So I'm going to leave that episode. Don't forget to smash the like button, subscribe. Today I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace.